Good morning.
Good morning, Johnny.
Thanks for coming over.
Oh, thanks for having me. This is great. We should. You've been saying that wildfire is a prominent concern for our valley, which it is, and I'd love to hear more from you about what's on the radar for you right now.
Well, I think that the drought, which is part of the water issue, all ties in with the fire risk. And we are an urban interface with the wildlands, and we've always had that as a danger or a risk. But it was far less when we weren't in drought, and the changing climate was more in our favor. And my responsibility as the mayor is the pre-planning part of this, the emergency plan and the mutual aid to get resources here to the first responders. Once the emergency starts, the sheriff, the fire chief, the city manager are the people who are in charge of this.
Tell me about what that looked like for you during the Thomas Fire when all that began to unfold. What were some of the things that you were in action mode around?
Well, first thing that happened is I got the Ventura alert on my Dick Tracy
Your
wrist,
technology.
my wrist radio at about 4 in the morning when the pumps in the upper Ojai burned and they lost the pressure on the water lines. And then being mandatorily evacuated and grabbing my spouse and a few belongings and relocating. But I was here every day communicating, going to City Hall, going to the Emergency Operating Center, going down to the command center of CAL FIRE, taking care of the communications with our state legislatures and people who will help us pay for all of this when it happens. And I thought that all worked, really well. But that fire moved twice as fast as anybody had ever seen one move because of the winds. So that meant that whatever you were being told, in minute one, by minute 10 possibly
Changes.
was totally different. Okay, so even the data coming from the central command post, they were having difficulties keeping up with it. And then we have modern technology with social media where everybody's talking to everybody, and now that makes the rumor control even more difficult.
Of course.
But if you look out your window and you see something, believe your eyes, don't believe something that might be stale
Because
on
it's
the bulletin
active
board.
and it's changing constantly.
And what's happening in your neighborhood may not even be on the radar of the bigger picture. Individual responsibility is going to be the key in not only future fires, but earthquake. There won't be a warning. And I just happen to bring this with me. But it's a
This is
really well done DVD on individual responsibility and preparation. People Like You is the Ready, Set, Go program, which is emphasizing that each of us individually, whether we like it or not, the reality is when they say go, you
You
should be
go.
ready to go. And what we're trying to do as a government is to set up those communication links to help you do that. But if they fail, or if someone is not doing their job,
It comes back to you
yeah,
and how you
right.
take care of yourself, your family, your
Exactly.
neighbors, how you work
Right.
together.
I think we as a city need to do more as far as amending our codes, for sprinklers and for the material we have on our roofs. We have to be conscious of the density of our town. Every planning decision, every land use decision, we need to look at through that filter. And my major effort is going to be to be sure everybody understands we don't really have fire zones. Where
You're
we in Ojai is, the fire hazard zone. You're either in it or you're not. We're in it.
We're in it. It's a
So,
full risk.
right, and it's year-round. So we have to harden the city. We have to the combustibles to be removed, the weed abatements on time, the homeowner maintenance, because we all have a collective responsibility to
Responsibility.
our neighbors.
It becomes a, it's a real community effort,
And it's easy to
that
forget in a community saying, nobody should tell me what I do on my property. Well, yeah, I'm all for that. But all of us, not because it's we intend to neglect, but we have other things to
And
do.
it's an easy thing. It can be out of sight, out of mind. You go back to life as normal and kind of settle in and forget. We really live in a vulnerable area.
There's two sides to almost everything, and the blessing is that we can forget and not be panicky and grieve all the time. And the bad side of that
It's
is
that we can get a
we
little lazy.
yeah, right. And so I see my effort to be devoted to trying to both get the codes upgraded. There's a lot of good work being done by the BAB, the Building Appeals Board, and between doing that, emphasizing more expenditure in the area like tree trimming. Didn't make that much difference when we had plenty of rain, but now we need to get the dead trees down. We need to remove the combustibles, and the city has responsibility, because when we go tell the homeowner to do it, and we haven't even done it in the public right of ways, you know, how much attention are they going to pay?
Sure.
So it's the community, or the city councils and the fire department. We are getting together with the school superintendent and all those, the lead of the Chamber of Commerce, and trying to come up with a program that constantly reinforces, not to scare everybody, but just to keep them on the alert.
Reminder.
So it's sort of lead by example, and I think we're doing better, but we got a ways to go.
Yeah.